Okay, welcome to Sport Karate Perspective. I'm Alex Reyes and this is Johnny Tension. And today we're talking about the rookie division. Okay, what's the rookie division, you ask? Well, at the Blitz Mind Tournament this year was a great tournament. We were there, Johnny was there too.
Yeah, I was there.
All right, and they had a division. I start seeing, what is this? And it's 18 to 20. It was called the rookie division. Now, we had a point fighter, all right? And most of the people said no. But I think that it's good.
Why do you always go against the grain?
It's rookie. Okay. Rookie. Look, a lot of times, why do I think it's good? I don't think it's really good. I mean, you're an adult. You go out there and fight adults. But see, that's the problem. You see, I'm talking about juniors. They're not transitioning to adults. You see them leaving because they're wearing the face shields. And they don't have to wear the face shields. They get hit harder. They're being baby too much in juniors. So when they go to adults, they come out. They lose. That's it. There's excuses about going to college and, oh, I don't have time. That's not true because that's always happened, right? They're scared. They can't win. Is this division going to do for them? Now, why do I like it? Not because I really like it, but because I want the sport to grow and give them an extra 2 years as a junior division or rookie, extended junior division, right? And call it rookie, right? And let them wait. Let's see if they grow up in 2 more years and can take a punch from Ross Levine. All right, that's why I think it should be.
Let me tell you what created the Ross Levines, the Raymond Daniels, I'm sure the Trevors of the world, getting beat up in the gym by an older fighter who was better, who brought you up, not cuddling you and saying. There's several factors. The fact of why they're not staying longer has nothing to do with their face shield or they get coddled. The factor is this. This is what people don't realize. Do you know why jiu-jitsu schools are growing so largely, or boxing is growing so largely, or kickboxing is growing so largely? Because you have a destination.
MMA?
What is it?
Right.
Exactly.
Okay.
With jiu-jitsu, even if you don't go into the UFC, you can see what your activity leads to, right? In boxing.
Yeah, you have jiu-jitsu schools that say they're doing MMA and they're doing no stand-up at all.
But the thing about it is that they'll go, I'm doing the same thing that BJ Penn does. Henzo does. I'm leading to something. In boxing, even if a kid never goes professional, he says, I'm doing what Floyd Mayweather does. In kickboxing, it's the same thing. They all lead to something. Karate guys, when you do sport karate, you cannot, they do it with an expectation for it to lead to someplace. And you just said that they're coddling them. The sport coddles the men. You're splitting up the diamonds now. You're splitting the overall grands. Oh, lightweight.
That's true.
And then you want to be called elite.
And there's 8 divisions.
You want to
Before that was an 8 divisions.
You want to sit on the couch with me.
Yeah.
I wanted to sit with Richard Platt. I want history to remember me the way it remembered them. You broke up. You're going to have a guy who went and has a diamond ring, and he'll be like, look. And he had another guy there that night that didn't win. That didn't lose. It's 2 of y'all. And they said, no, y'all don't got to fight each other. One of y'all is bigger and stronger. So the cuddling comes, it comes from the head down. So you have a sport who we all know is a niche sport that we love it, but it has no destination. I remember this.
I think it has a destination, especially now. There's a,
where?
It's happening.
Where?
It's not yet, it's
where?
Happening.
Don't say the Olympics.
No.
Where?
Raymond Daniels, Stephen Thompson. Stephen Thompson, I don't consider you a point fighter for real. He just did. Michael Page. Northcutt.
They're opening
doors for us, and they have that point fighting style. They still have to do jiu-jitsu wrestling.
No, but they are opening the doors
for karate.
Listen to what I just
said.
In
the UFC.
Listen to what you
just
said.
And Glory and Bellator kickboxing.
Wrong mindset.
Point fighters could kickbox.
Listen to me. Wrong mentality.
Leo Valdivia is coming.
You're saying that. Listen. This is what I'm just trying to say. Why can't point fighting, done correctly, be good enough just to be point fighting? Why do we need the validation? Let me tell you a story. This is a true story. I didn't tell a lot of people this. I was in Paris doing a seminar. It was me and Raymond Daniels doing a seminar together. We had like about 80 kickboxers. We was going over point karate drills, and then kickboxers like real kickboxers, not point kickboxers, right? And the guy was like, well, we just want to see how these techniques could be relevant for what we did. So we tweaked them a little bit.
They couldn't
and
touch
we boxed
you.
Them. No, we did well, right? Yeah. So in the intermission, me and Raymond was changing, and Raymond said to me, yo, Jay, quote, word for word, yo, Jay, You ever feel like you wasted your talent doing this? Like you could have been a great boxer or, and I said to Ray, you ever thought about that? And I was like, yeah, I thought about it, but Ray, this is what I want to do. Like this is what I want to do. And he kind of was like, I could tell that he felt like all his potential was wasted doing this, which now you see him going into the other stuff.
Yes.
Because this didn't secure him enough.
Because of the money, right.
Whatever it is, right. For me, I didn't do it for the money. I just wanted to be great, Alex, at something. So my whole point is that these kids, you got now kids that are 13, 14 years old who will tell you they won a diamond in the Nationals and they got a diamond ring. That won the 14-year-old division or won the junior division and get the same award that you got. And they feel this sense of accomplishment.
They're at the same level.
Imagine giving a kid a kid graduating high school getting a college degree. Yeah. And y'all share the stage together. Y'all share the limelight together. And he's going to feel with his arrogant ass at 16, 15. He's an equal.
Now you have 12-year-olds that are third degree black belts. Traditionally, you're not supposed to be a black belt till you're about, 15, 16?
It's the age of reason.
Age, right?
You know, that's how you used to be. The business, the whole industry as far as tournament goes, is a whole other
thing. Yeah, but that's a kid black belt still. But still, it's on the same thing of putting them on stage. They're at the same level. Yeah, they want a diamond.
Yeah.
I'm just like Raymond Daniels.
Absolutely.
I'm trying to tell you, Ross, I'm the same. I'm at the same level. So when it gets hard, I already did I'm out of here.
Absolutely.
But I think that's what it comes down to, right?
You have
the heat, it gets too hot for them in the kitchen.
Yeah,
they
but
get
that's
out
part
of, there.
Of it. But the bottom line is you can stay. Listen, you know, it ain't that boxing has the greatest retention. It's the reason why boxing has a retention because you know that potentially there's $1 million payday. There's UFC, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a payday. Wrestling is a payday. These things have sports that support their bottom line. Like a Jiu-Jitsu school would be filled with guys. Just even if they're not there fully for the jiu-jitsu, but they know they need jiu-jitsu for MMA, they'll be in that jiu-jitsu school.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm trying to say?
That's
we don't have a thing that makes you go, how many UFC schools will go?
So you don't think, so with that being said, you don't think a rookie division will be good?
I think that's not, I think that's not solving the problem.
I think it would.
No, because it doesn't.
Because they'll have those juniors stay in there
okay,
longer.
So you said
and they may end up quitting, but at least they're still in the sport.
Okay,
and you never know, they may end up getting stronger.
So rookie of the year should never have to play against Jordan because what?
No, they should be able to
when
compete.
Does he fight Ross?
No.
When
no,
does he fight Raymond
no,
Daniels?
No, they should be able to have 18 to 20 division, right? But that goes first, right? Or separate. You have the option to fight there. But if you don't, if you're Ross Levine that went out there and won his rookie year, he won his first tournament as an adult, he won the AK Grants, right? If you feel like you can do it, you go in there. But if you don't, you go in that division, right? Just to keep it going. Just to kind of like, you know, I don't feel it should be that way, the whole adult system, like the US Open does, where there's elite and non-elite. I don't think that's where it should go.
So what is 18 to 20?
Right?
That's the same thing, you say.
18 to 20, yes.
18 to 20 is the same thing, Alex?
But no, it's an extended junior division.
Okay. Oh, so
and then
basically,
after they turn 21, if you want to quit, then you go ahead and quit, right? If you're soft, right? If you can't hang with adults.
It has nothing to do with soft.
It is about being soft.
No, Alex,
these parents are coddling their kids, putting face masks, and all these people.
And you're coddling them by saying
everybody wins. Everybody wins. No, put them in there, right? I remember my first time fighting adults.
You got an 18 to 20 year old division in your karate school? Do the kids fight the men in the karate school? We may not beat them up as hard.
Fight my kids.
All right then. When adults get their black belts, every kid that you know, listen, I know that when you get your black belt, it's a tough moment that you go through.
Yeah.
So you telling me you should be able to go through that tough moment, earn your black belt from Sensei or Shihan, whoever, and then go to a tournament with rules and referees and even have that baby? You already got rules. You already got a referee. You already got a 2-minute round. You don't got 3 2-minute rounds. You telling me that the
I'm just looking at the answer. How can we get more 16, 17
okay,
year
so
olds
check this out. Let me
to
ask
move
question.
Up to 18?
Sure.
That's the solution. That's the problem here.
Check
you have
out.
2 or 3 moving up to adults from 16 and 17.
You got
this will get more kids kids to stay, right? Adding that division. And you never know. Maybe if they don't quit, they stay there, it could become that.
Yeah, but that is a thing that is based on your
passion. And it's just society.
Not your division.
Kids are growing up
slower. Mafia Holloway wanted to fight the men when the
kids got it too easy. It's a thing of society.
Mafia Holloway wanted to fight the men. at 16 years
old. Me too.
Old.
I fought men.
In 1986. Yeah. I remember a videotape. My eyes are closed because the
you
passion is there.
You don't see that happen anymore. Wait,
in Mitchell's gym in the Bronx, I see a big Mafia Holloway fighting K.A. Little Boy. And he did not need, that is why we celebrate a Mafia Holloway. But you're saying that Lil Mikey should no. have an extra 2-3 more no. years in the baby division no. before he fight Raw. Wait, check this
not
out.
Not Mafia.
Wait, check this out. Listen to this.
Not Mafia.
Listen to what I'm saying.
But Joe Smoke.
Okay.
Yes,
Joe Smoke should have an extra 2-3 years in the division. So when he's 20, he fights a 28, 27, 29-year-old Ross.
Yes.
What, he loses yes. out on the experience of fighting yes. an 18-year-old Ross fighting an 18-year-old Junior.
No, because if he's good enough, he'll go in there. If he sees that it's too hard, right? Most of the people that go in that division are soft already. They probably won't make it past. At least they'll stay. But you never know if one comes out good. That's what I'm saying.
Your mentality determines.
My mentality.
Not me going, all right, you can fight the kids that are not so good, so I can puff up the ego.
But that's the way it is here. Now, society's different now. Everybody gets a trophy.
They went 13 to 14, 15 to 16, 17 to 18, 18 to 19, 19 to 20. They come out. Yeah, I got 6, 7, 8 years of success. 18 to 20. They come out.
Yeah, they're
first,
more.
First fight is
Trevor
Nash. You're
giving them like, no, they ain't going to fight Trevor Nash.
First Nash is Trevor Nash Jason Morelli. I'm just hypothetically saying, like,
you never
first
know.
Fight is Brian Root. He gotta have that mentality. You got dudes that wanna sneak in the men's division, and now you're giving me you saying that we should make a division for guys yes. who wanna prolong
rookie.
It.
Rookie division, what do you guys think? 18 to 20, yes
man,
or no?
You
who won? Promoters like this.
I can't fight.
Promoters
physically.
Like this.
I can't debate physically.
Promoters like this.
Don't listen, this is absolutely ridiculous.
Promoters. Say it.
It's absolutely ridiculous. And those guys should have the opportunity to fight those other guys younger. And if you have the right mentality, it will
it's
make
also
you
good
better.
For business. You're getting people to stay. Okay. Alright, you're getting people to stay. It's good for the sport. More fighters instead of people quitting. Because they're quitting.
They're quitting. The sport needs to create another ceiling. And the sport needs to create
That could be something.
Some
are quitting
schools.
For that reason, but some are quitting because they can't.
Let me tell you something, man. I wanted to do MMA. I'm brown belt Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I got invited. I never tell anybody this. I got invited to a UFC UFC camp with a top-notch guy after they watched me do my striking. And this sport karate thing is what I love. It's just what I love. So you can want to do MMA, you can want to do all those things. But if you love this, you're not gonna do it for the. And
you love it and you're good at it. Why would somebody quit when they're not good?
This guy's that quit. That's good, man. But again,
at the end of the day, if you don't win, you quit.
Because you did it for the wrong reasons.
Right? If you don't win, you're not putting in the work. You're not winning. You quit. That's it. That's how it works.
There has to be a ceiling. There has to be some sense of retention, and not because I share a diamond ring with a dude who doesn't want to fight the men's. And this is the crazy thing. You share diamond rings with a dude who doesn't want to fight the
what
men's.
What are you talking about? Who's
listen.
Winning a diamond ring? You don't
give
me...
these juniors, man. They're getting these diamond rings.
He's
doing 14 and 15. I want a diamond ring.
That's horrible.
You're rewarding them as though... I'm not saying they shouldn't get rewards because I understand the incentive.
Give them rewards,
yeah,
yes.
But you got to say, this is the...
There should be a separate spotlight. You want to spotlight the juniors, spotlight them separately. Spotlight the men separately from them on a different stage.
You remember when your father walked in the house?
I do agree that.
You remember when your father walked in the house and your mother made a plate of food, but you ain't have as much food as he has. He had the bigger piece of chicken.
Yeah.
That's how the adult division is supposed to be. They supposed to have the bigger piece
of
chicken.
Yeah, but now kids want the same amount.
God damn it, then pay your dues.
I know my daughter wants the same.
Right
she's
way.
Always like, how come he got two slices? I want two. That's the way kids
are. You have a kid who wins an 18 to 29 year old division, who's the man 18 to 20, who never fought the elite, is gonna look at you and say, I'm entitled to a sponsorship.
No.
And you're gonna put him on WKF.
No.
Why not? He won 18 to 29. This is good.
18 to 20. No, but
that's it.
That's like a novice division too.
Okay.
You know, you call it like that, you don't give them prize money, give them a trophy. That's it, they stay. All right? What do you think?
Because of your mentality. Because your own personal
training. Rookie year,
not because with the trophies
compete.
Like.
It's crazy. My rookie year, I went to compete and I won. I won lightweight grand. Crazy. Then I was like, this is easy. Wow, but then it got harder. All right, I beat Brady, and then he got me back, and he whooped my butt.
How many times? Yeah, that's right?
I was like, oh man, it's not so easy. Okay.
Yeah.
That was great fighting him. It was so good. And when I fought Pedro as a rookie, I was a rookie, 97 in team fighting. It felt.
Did you have to wait 2 years?
But I wasn't scared.
Did you have to wait?
But I wasn't a scared little pansy.
So it's the mentality that makes you fight.
But that's the mentality that there is now. Was I scared? I was scared to fight Brady.
Those kids should
be cater to. Was I scared to fight Pedro in team fighting, U.S. Open? Yeah, I was scared. All right, but I was stepped up to challenge. But now kids are being brought up to be scared and to run. All right, what do you guys think? Let us know. Rookie division, yes!
Point fighter, the perspective.
Sport karate perspective.